Now we'll take exercise 2.1 of parallel lines, question number 2. In this question number 2, you are given that line P and Q, they are parallel to each other and there are two transversal. One transversal is L, another is M. You have been given certain measures. You have to find out the measures of angle B, angle A, angle C and angle D using the properties of parallel lines. Okay. So, as here we have two transversal, it is essential for you to state which transversal you are using in this sum. Okay. So, line P is parallel to line Q. Fine. Now, for this transversal L, we have the alternate angles congruent. See this pair of alternate angle. Okay, so angle B will be of what measure? Angle B will be of 110 degree. So for transversal L, angle B is equal to 110 degree, since what kind of angles are they? They are alternate angles. Over. So we found out the measure of angle B, put it in a rectangular box. Now if you have a look at angle A and 110, they are angles in a linear pair. Okay, they have a common arm, their non-common arms form opposite rays. So angle A and angle 110 are angles in a linear pair. So now we make use of this property, that is angles in a linear pair, their sum is 180. So now angle A plus 110 is equal to 180. Reason is, since angles in linear pair. Okay, my reason has to be given. So therefore, what will be angle A? Angle A will be 180. This 110 will go to the right hand side, so you will write it as minus 110. So what will be your measure of angle A? It will be 70 degree. Fine. Okay, so we got angle A also, we got angle B. Now we are left out with angle C and angle D. Again, come to these parallel lines. Line P is parallel to line Q, if you see the figure, and this is the transversal M. For this transversal M, you can see corresponding angle C and 115, they are corresponding angles, so they will be congruent. So what will be measure of angle C? It will be 115 degree. Okay, so now we take also, okay, also for P parallel to Q and line M as the transversal, angle C is equal to 115. Reason is, since corresponding angles. Okay, so you got angle C equal to 115. Now which angle is left? Angle D is left. Now if you have a look at these two angles, they are again angles in a linear pair, so you can get it as what kind of angles? Angles in a linear pair. Or you can also go for angle A and angle D. Angle A and angle D are exterior alternate angles. Okay, so their sum will be 180. Any of these two, whichever you find convenient to take. Okay, so I'll go for angles in a linear pair. So here we go for angle डी प्लस 115 इज इक्वल टू 180. नाउ एंगल डी प्लस 115 इज इक्वल टू 180 सिंस एंगल्स इन लीनियर पेयर. So angle D will be equal to 180 minus 115. So angle D will be equal to how much? That will come out to be 10 minus 5 is how much? 5. Here is 7. 7 minus 1 will be 65 degree. Okay? Yes or no? So we got angle D equal to how much? That angle is equal to 65 degree. Okay, actually angle D and angle A are not, they are not in exterior alternate angles. Exterior alternate angles will be this. Okay, so you will have to go for angles in a linear pair only. Please keep that in mind. Okay, so we got the measure of angle D as 65 degree. I hope you got this sum. Now we go for the next sum also. The next sum, question number 3. We have two parallel lines, two pairs of parallel lines. One is line N is parallel to line P and another one is line L is parallel to line M. Aapko diya hai L is parallel to M. Aapko diya hai N is parallel to M. N is parallel to P. वन ऑफ द एंगल इज गिवन टू यू. आपको फाइंड करना है मेजर ऑफ एंगल ए बी एन सी. ठीक है, तो यहाँ पे भी आपको कौन सी पैरेलल लाइंस आप यूज कर रहे हो वो मेंशन करना जरूरी है और कौन सी ट्रांसवर्सल है दैट ऑल्सो यू हैव टू स्टेट. तो अब देखो, हम लेंगे लाइन एल और पी अगर पैरेलल है. आर यू गेटिंग दैट? सो फॉर दैट पर्पस you will need 445 degree this angle. दिख रहा है ना? ये जो एंगल है इसको ये ए से मार्क किया हुआ है. एक्चुअली दिस इज योर एंगल ए, नॉट दिस. ये वाला नहीं है फिगर में, आपको ऐसा दिख रहा है, लेकिन एक्चुअली दिस इज द एंगल ए दैट यू हैव टू गो फॉर. ठीक है, सो हम लिखेंगे एल इज पैरेलल टू एम which is the transversal, P is the transversal, line P is the transversal. Therefore, angle A will be equal to 45 degree. कैसे angles है ये? Corresponding angles. So you write the reason, since corresponding angles. ठीक है, ओके. नाउ एंगल ए और एंगल बी कैसे एंगल्स है? दे आर एंगल्स इन अ लीनियर पेयर, सो देयर सम विल बी 180. नाउ एंगल ए प्लस एंगल बी इज इक्वल टू 180 सिंस एंगल्स इन लीनियर पेयर. ठीक है, दे आर एंगल्स इन लीनियर पेयर. सो ए का मेजर कितना भी निकाले आपने 45, 45 प्लस बी इज इक्वल टू 180. सो एंगल बी विल बी 180 माइनस 45 डिग्री. सो एंगल बी विल बी इक्वल टू हाउ मच? सी 10 माइनस 5 इज 5. यहाँ पे 7 बचा, 7 में से 4 गया 3, है ना, एंड 135. So what is measure of angle B? It is 135. Okay? अब B भी मिल गया आपको. This angle is of 135. Line N is parallel to line P. N is parallel to P. अगर आप ये transversal लेंगे तो ये दोनों angles कैसे हो गए? Corresponding angles हो गए. So their measures will be same. Okay? So we have to mention now. For which two lines parallel? N parallel to P and transversal is M and transversal M. Angle C is equal to angle B. What is the reason? Since corresponding angles, ठीक है ना, they are corresponding angles. But angle B का मेजर कितना है? 135. ये यहाँ पे भी आपने करे, so angle C का मेजर कितना आ गया? 135. Okay, students, any queries, any doubt you have, put it in the comment box and please subscribe to my channel. It's a humble request.